वेलकम टू साइटक AI यूटोपिया। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू 30 वेज ए प्लैनेट कैन बी टेराफॉर्म्ड और मेड हैबिटेबल फॉर ह्यूमन लाइफ। टेराफॉर्मिंग द एम्बिशियस एंडेवर ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग ए सेलेस्टियल बॉडी टू मेक इट हैबिटेबल फॉर ह्यूमन लाइफ इन्वॉल्व्स ए मल्टीफेसेटेड एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकली एडवांस्ड प्रोसेस। द प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू मॉडिफाई द प्लैनेट्स नेचुरल कंडीशंस इंक्लूडिंग इट्स एटमोस्फेयर टेम्परेचर एंड सरफेस फीचर्स टू रिसेम्बल अर्थ्स हॉस्पिटेबल एनवायरनमेंट। कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द प्लैनेट्स नेटिव कंडीशंस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इन कंपासिंग द एनालिसिस ऑफ एटमोस्फेरिक कंपोजिशन सरफेस जियोलॉजी एंड क्लाइमेट डायनामिक्स। टेराफॉर्मिंग मेथोडोलॉजीज वेरी रेंजिंग फ्रॉम द इंट्रोडक्शन और रिमूवल ऑफ स्पेसिफिक गैसेज थ्रू जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ फ्लोरा टू लार्ज स्केल इंजीनियरिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स सच एज ऑर्बिटल मिरर्स और सोलर शेड्स टू रेगुलेट सनलाइट एक्सपोजर। नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी प्लेस ए पिवोटल रोल इन प्रेसिजन इन एटमोस्फेरिक मैनिपुलेशन थ्रू द डिप्लॉयमेंट ऑफ नैनो बॉट्स फॉर रियल टाइम मॉनिटरिंग एंड कंट्रोल्ड एडजस्टमेंट। द अडेप्टेशन ऑफ इंडिजिनस और जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिजम्स कपल्ड विथ एडवांस्ड टेक्नोलॉजीज इंश्योर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग इकोसिस्टम्स कैपेबल ऑफ सपोर्टिंग ह्यूमन लाइफ। इन एसेंस टेराफॉर्मिंग रिप्रेजेंट्स ह्यूमैनिटीज ऑडेशियस अटेम्प्ट टू एक्सटेंड इट्स हैबिटेट बियॉन्ड अर्थ पुशिंग द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ साइंस इंजीनियरिंग एंड एनवायरमेंटल स्टीवर्डशिप। यू मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट टेराफॉर्मिंग ऑफ मार्स। टेराफॉर्मिंग होल्ड्स पैरामाउंट इंपॉर्टेंस एज इट अलाइंस विद द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नॉट पुटिंग ऑल एग्स इंटू वन बास्केट प्रोवाइडिंग ए स्ट्रेटजिक एंड लॉन्ग टर्म अप्रोच टू ह्यूमन सर्वाइवल एंड एक्सप्लोरेशन। The significance lies in creating alternative habitats beyond Earth, reducing humanity's dependence on a single celestial body for its continued existence. If unforeseen catastrophic events threaten Earth, having terraformed planets as viable habitats offers a crucial insurance policy for the continuity of human civilization. By expanding our presence to other habitable worlds, we mitigate the risks associated with a single point of failure. Earth faces various threats ranging from asteroid impacts and climate change to other existential risks. Terraforming Mars, for instance, could serve as a backup plan, preserving human knowledge, culture, and the potential for a flourishing society in the face of unforeseen challenges on Earth. This diversification of habitats not only safeguards against extinction-level events but also opens new frontiers for exploration, resource utilization, and scientific discovery. It reflects humanity's commitment to resilience, adaptability, and the pursuit of a multiplanetary existence that transcends vulnerabilities associated with sole reliance on Earth. Let us get into 30 ways a planet can be terraformed. Number 1. Atmospheric manipulation. It begins by analyzing the target planet's current atmospheric composition, density, and pressure. Understand the specific gases needed for a habitable environment. It introduces gases strategically, considering their impact on temperature, pressure, and the potential for sustaining life. Common gases include oxygen, nitrogen, and trace elements. It employs advanced technology such as atmospheric processors or terraforming stations to release and distribute gases. This may involve deploying atmospheric probes to target specific regions. We also need to continuously monitor the evolving atmosphere, adjusting the introduction of gases to maintain a stable, supportive environment for life. It involves addressing potential challenges such as atmospheric escape by implementing long-term solutions like magnetic shielding to retain gases against solar wind erosion. Number 2. Orbital mirrors. Launch a network of large mirrors into orbit around the target planet, strategically positioned to intercept and redirect sunlight. Utilize precision orbital calculations to ensure optimal sunlight redirection, avoiding overcooling or overheating of specific regions on the planet's surface. Implement a dynamic control system to adjust the orientation of mirrors ऑप्टिमाइजिंग द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सनलाइट बेस्ड ऑन द प्लैनेट्स रोटेशन एंड ऑर्बिट. कंसिडर द इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ ऑटोमेटेड मेंटेनेंस सिस्टम्स टू एड्रेस इशूज लाइक डस्ट एक्यूमुलेशन ऑन मिरर सर्फेसेस, इंश्योरिंग कंसिस्टेंट सनलाइट रीडायरेक्शन एफिशियंसी. इस्टैब्लिश ए कॉम्प्रीहेंसिव पावर सप्लाई सिस्टम फॉर द ऑर्बिटल मिरर्स, पोटेंशियली इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग सोलर पैनल्स और अदर सस्टेनेबल एनर्जी सोर्सेस टू मेंटेन लॉन्ग टर्म फंक्शनैलिटी. नंबर 3, मैग्नेटिक शील्डिंग. डिप्लॉय मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जनरेटर्स और मैग्नेटिक शील्डिंग डिवाइसेस इन ऑर्बिट अराउंड द टारगेट प्लैनेट टू एस्टैब्लिश ए प्रोटेक्टिव बैरियर अगेंस्ट सोलर विंड. कैलकुलेट द रिक्वायर्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ बेस्ड ऑन द प्लैनेट्स साइज, कंपोजिशन एंड डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम इट्स स्टार. एडजस्टमेंट्स मे बी नेसेसरी टू बैलेंस प्रोटेक्शन एंड अलो फॉर नेचुरल इंटरेक्शंस विद द सोलर विंड. मॉनिटर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कंटिन्यूअसली एम्प्लॉइंग एडवांस्ड सेंसर्स एंड सैटेलाइट सिस्टम्स टू डिटेक्ट फ्लक्चुएशंस एंड मेक रियल टाइम एडजस्टमेंट्स. एड्रेस पोटेंशियल साइड इफेक्ट्स सच एज इंटरफेरेंस विद कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स और ऑर्बिटल डायनामिक्स थ्रू केयरफुली इंजीनियरिंग एंड एडवांस्ड कंट्रोल एल्गोरिथम्स. कंसिडर लॉन्ग टर्म मेंटेनेंस स्ट्रेटजीज टू इंश्योर द सस्टेन्ड फंक्शनैलिटी ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक शील्डिंग, पोटेंशियली इन्वॉल्विंग ऑटोनोमस रिपेयर सिस्टम्स और पीरियोडिक एडजस्टमेंट्स बेस्ड ऑनगोइंग ऑब्जर्वेशंस. नंबर 4, कार्बन कैप्चर. डेवलप ए कॉम्प्रीहेंसिव सर्वे ऑफ द प्लैनेट्स करेंट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड लेवल्स, आइडेंटिफाइंग सोर्सेस एंड सिंक्स विद इन द एटमोस्फेयर एंड सर्फेस. इम्प्लीमेंट ए मल्टीफेसेटेड कार्बन कैप्चर स्ट्रेटजी यूटिलाइजिंग एडवांस्ड टेक्नोलॉजीज सच एज डायरेक्ट एयर कैप्चर, ओशन बेस्ड मेथड्स एंड लैंड बेस्ड कार्बन सिक्वेस्ट्रेशन. डिप्लॉय अ रेस ऑफ कार्बन कैप्चर डिवाइसेस अक्रॉस द प्लैनेट स्ट्रेटजिकली प्लेस्ड टू मैक्सिमाइज एफिशिएंसी इन एक्सट्रैक्टिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड फ्रॉम द एटमोसफेयर. एक्सप्लोर इनोवेटिव मटेरियल्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजीज फॉर एफिशियंट कार्बन एब्जॉर्प्शन, स्टोरेज एंड पोटेंशियल यूटिलाइजेशन टू अवॉइड अनइंटेंडेड एनवायरमेंटल कंसिक्वेंसेस. इंटीग्रेट ए रोबस्ट मॉनिटरिंग सिस्टम टू ट्रैक चेंजेस इन एटमोस्फेरिक कार्बन लेवल्स एंड असेस द इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ कैप्चर मेथड्स ओवर टाइम. नंबर 5, जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग. कंडक्ट ए थोरो एनालिसिस ऑफ द प्लैनेट्स एग्जिस्टिंग इकोसिस्टम्स एंड आइडेंटिफाई पोटेंशियल जेनेटिक मॉडिफिकेशंस नीडेड फॉर ऑर्गेनिजम्स टू थ्राइव इन द न्यू एनवायरनमेंट. डेवलप एडवांस्ड जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग टेक्निक्स टू क्रिएट ऑर्गेनिजम्स केपेबल ऑफ अडेप्टिंग टू द अल्टर्ड एटमोस्फेरिक एंड एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस. डिजाइन सिंथेटिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स विथ एनहांस्ड रेजिलियंस, रिसोर्स यूटिलाइजेशन एंड द एबिलिटी टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट पॉजिटिवली टू द टेराफॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस सच एज रिलीजिंग ऑक्सीजन और नाइट्रोजन फिक्सिंग बैक्टीरिया. इम्प्लीमेंट कंट्रोल्ड रिलीज ऑफ जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन टू द एनवायरमेंट कंसिडरिंग इकोलॉजिकल इम्पैक्ट असेसमेंट्स एंड पोटेंशियल इंटरेक्शंस विद एग्जिस्टिंग लाइफ फॉर्म्स. इस्टैब्लिश कंटिन्यूस मॉनिटरिंग एंड कंटेनमेंट मेजर्स टू प्रिवेंट अनइंटेंडेड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस और इकोलॉजिकल डिसरप्शंस caused by the introduction of genetically engineered organisms. Number 6, nanotechnology. Engineer nanobots with specialized functions including atmospheric manipulation, surface alteration and targeted resource distribution. Develop a deployment strategy for nanobots considering factors such as dispersal mechanism, self-replication controls and communication protocols to coordinate actions. Implement advanced AI systems to manage the nanobot swarm, ensuring coordination and adaptability to dynamic environmental changes. Integrate safety mechanisms to prevent unintended consequences such as nanobot malfunction or uncontrolled replication, and establish fail-safes for rapid response in case of unexpected events. Continuously monitor the nanobot swarm's progress using remote sensing and feedback loops to make real-time adjustments and address emerging challenges during the terraforming process. Number 7, albedo modification. Conduct a comprehensive analysis of the planet's surface characteristics, including reflectivity or albedo of different materials such as rocks, ice, and vegetation. Develop a surface modification strategy to alter the planet's albedo, either by introducing reflective materials or changing the properties of existing surfaces. Deploy automated systems or robotic missions to implement surface modifications, considering factors such as energy efficiency, scalability, and the long-term stability of altered surfaces. Utilize advanced modeling and simulation tools to predict the impact of albedo modifications on the planet's temperature, climate, and overall habitability. Implement a monitoring network, including satellites and ground-based sensors, to assess the effectiveness of albedo modification and make real-time adjustments as needed. Number 8. Solar shades. Design and deploy a network of solar shades or sun shields in space to intercept and partially block incoming sunlight. Consider the optimal size, shape, and placement of the shades to balance the reduction of solar radiation with potential impacts on planetary temperature and climate. Develop a sophisticated control system to adjust the position and orientation of the shades dynamically, accounting for the planet's orbit, rotation, and seasonal variations. Address potential challenges such as eclipsing natural events or unintended consequences like temperature imbalances through advanced modeling and continuous monitoring. Establish protocols for periodic maintenance and potential repositioning of solar shades, taking into account long-term changes in the planet's environment. Number 9. Space mirrors. Launch and position an array of large mirrors in orbit around the planet to redirect sunlight selectively to different regions. Develop precise orbital mechanics and navigation systems to ensure accurate positioning of the mirrors and to optimize the distribution of sunlight on the planet's surface. Implement a real-time control system that adjusts the orientation of the mirrors to account for the planet's rotation and orbit, preventing localized overheating or cooling. Integrate advanced materials for the mirrors, considering factors such as reflectivity, durability, and resistance to space debris and radiation. Establish redundant communication systems and fail-safes to address potential malfunctions or unexpected events, ensuring the continuous and controlled operation of the space mirror network. Number 10. Tidal force manipulation. Conduct a thorough analysis of the planet's natural satellites and their gravitational effects on tidal forces. Develop a computational model to simulate changes in tidal forces based on alterations to the orbit, mass, or characteristics of the natural satellites. Implement a controlled approach to manipulate tidal forces, considering the impact on the planet's climate, geology, and potential for habitability. Deploy advanced spacecraft or technologies capable of influencing the orbit or characteristics of the natural satellites to achieve the desired tidal force modifications. Establish continuous monitoring systems to assess the effectiveness of tidal force manipulation and address any unforeseen consequences or unintended side effects in real time. Number 11. Geoengineering. Conduct an extensive survey of the planet's geological composition, including crust structure, mineral distribution, and tectonic activity. Develop a geoengineering strategy to modify the planet's geology, involving processes such as controlled seismic activity, volcanic interventions, or the introduction of specific minerals. Implement advanced technologies capable of triggering controlled geological events, ensuring precision and predictability in the terraforming process. Integrate real-time monitoring systems, including seismic sensors and satellite observations, to track changes in the planet's geological features and respond to any unexpected developments promptly. Address potential ethical and environmental concerns associated with large-scale geoengineering, incorporating ethical frameworks and international cooperation in the decision-making process. Number 12. Biological inoculation. Analyze the planet's existing biosphere, if any, to understand its biodiversity, ecological dynamics, and potential for adaptation to new life forms. develop genetically modified microorganisms tailored to thrive in the planet's altered conditions and contribute positively to ecosystem development. Design a controlled release mechanism for introducing these modified microorganisms, taking into account potential ecological interactions and minimizing the risk of unintended consequences. Implement comprehensive monitoring systems, including genetic tracking and ecological surveys, to assess the impact of biological inoculation and guide subsequent interventions. Establish protocols for adaptive management, allowing for adjustments to the biological inoculation strategy based on ongoing observation and feedback from the evolving planetary ecosystem. Number 13, mass drivers. Begin by identifying valuable resources required for terraforming, such as minerals, water, or gases, both on the target planet and in nearby celestial bodies. Develop a network of mass drivers, electromagnetic catapults, or accelerators designed to launch payloads from the planet's surface into space. Implement a precise targeting system to direct payloads towards specific destinations, whether to transport resources from the planet or to influence celestial bodies that could impact the terraforming process. Consider energy-efficient propulsion methods like magnetic or electromagnetic acceleration to minimize the environmental impact and maximize payload capacity. Integrate automated systems for loading, launching, and navigating payloads, minimizing the need for human intervention and ensuring efficiency in resource extraction and transportation. Number 14, fusion bombs. Explore the possibility of controlled nuclear fusion reactors to alter the planet's composition and atmospheric conditions. Develop a sophisticated fusion bomb delivery system capable of precise deployment and controlled detonation. Conduct extensive simulations and modeling to predict the effects of fusion explosions on the planet's core, atmosphere, and surface, ensuring the desired terraforming outcomes. Establish safety measures, fail-safes, and ethical considerations to mitigate potential risks and environmental impacts associated with nuclear fusion-based terraforming. Implement real-time monitoring systems to assess the results of fusion bomb interventions, allowing for adjustments and refinements to the terraforming strategy based on observed outcomes. Number 15, geochemical processes. Analyze the planet's current geochemical processes, including weathering, erosion, and mineral cycling, to understand natural mechanisms that can be accelerated or modified. Develop a comprehensive plan for geochemical interventions, considering the introduction of specific minerals, catalyzing chemical reactions, or altering the rates of natural processes. Implement advanced technologies to carry out targeted geochemical modifications, potentially involving autonomous robotic systems or controlled releases of chemical agents. Conduct ongoing monitoring of geochemical changes through satellite observations, ground-based sensors, and sample analysis to evaluate the effectiveness of the interventions and make informed decisions for subsequent steps. Address potential environmental consequences and unintended side effects through adaptive management strategies, adjusting the geochemical processes based on real-time data and feedback. Number 16, habitat domes. Conduct a detailed analysis of the target planet's atmospheric conditions, temperature variations, and radiation levels to design habitat domes that can sustain human life. Develop advanced materials for dome construction, considering factors such as durability, insulation, and resistance to external environmental conditions. Implement a modular design for habitat domes, allowing for scalability and flexibility in accommodating various functions such as agriculture, housing, and recreational spaces. Integrate life support systems within the domes, including air circulation, waste management, and water recycling, to create a self-sustaining environment for inhabitants. consider energy sources such as solar panels or advanced power systems to meet the needs of the habitat domes, ensuring long-term viability and independence from external resources. Number 17. Space mirrors. Design and deploy a constellation of mirrors in orbit around the target planet, precisely positioned to reflect sunlight onto specific areas of the surface. Utilize advanced orbital dynamics calculations to optimize the arrangement of mirrors, accounting for the planet's rotation, orbit, and seasonal variations. Implement a control system that adjusts the orientation of each mirror in real time, responding to changes in sunlight intensity and ensuring even distribution across targeted regions. Consider materials with high reflectivity and durability for the mirrors, addressing challenges such as degradation due to space conditions and potential impacts from micrometeorites or space debris. Establish redundant communication and control systems to mitigate the risks of mirror malfunctions, ensuring continuous and reliable sunlight redirection. Number 18. Water redistribution. Conduct a comprehensive survey of the planet's existing water resources, including ice deposits, underground aquifers, and surface water sources. Develop a water redistribution strategy to move water to desired locations, balancing the creation of oceans, lakes, and rivers to support diverse ecosystems. Implement advanced technology for water transportation, potentially utilizing robotic systems, pipelines, or controlled releases from storage reservoirs. Model the impact of water redistribution on the planet's climate, taking into account factors such as evaporation, precipitation, and the influence on atmospheric conditions. Establish monitoring systems, including satellite observations and ground-based sensors, to track changes in water distribution and assess the success of the redistribution strategy over time. Number 19. Subsurface heating. Conduct a thorough analysis of the target planet's subsurface composition, identifying regions with potential heat-retaining materials such as minerals or trapped gases. Develop a subsurface heating strategy to raise the temperature of specific areas, releasing gases or altering geological conditions to enhance habitability. Implement advanced drilling technologies capable of reaching significant depths to access subsurface layers without causing environmental harm. Design controlled heating systems, potentially using geothermal energy or other sustainable sources, to avoid unintended consequences such as excessive temperature increases or disturbances to the planetary mantle. Integrate a comprehensive monitoring network, including subsurface sensors and satellite observations, to assess the effectiveness of subsurface heating and detect any emergent issues in real time. Number 20. Solar wind deflection. Analyze the target planet's magnetic field strength and susceptibility to solar wind, considering factors such as distance from the host star and atmospheric composition. Develop a solar wind deflection strategy, potentially involving the deployment of large magnetic sails or shield-like structures in space to protect the planet's atmosphere. Implement advanced magnetic field generators or technologies capable of producing a protective barrier against solar wind without negatively impacting the planet's natural magnetic field. Model the interaction between the artificial magnetic field and solar wind to optimize the deflection process and minimize energy consumption. Establish a continuous monitoring system to assess the effectiveness of solar wind deflection and make real-time adjustments based on solar activity and changing planetary conditions. Number 21. Bioengineered forests. Conduct an in-depth analysis of the target planet's soil composition, climate, and atmospheric conditions to determine suitable plant species for bioengineering. Develop genetically modified plant species with enhanced adaptability to the planetary environment, such as resistance to extreme temperatures, efficient nutrient absorption, and rapid growth. Design a controlled release and propagation strategy for introducing bioengineered plant species, considering ecological impact assessments and potential interactions with existing flora and fauna. Implement advanced monitoring systems, including remote sensing and on-site observations, to track the growth and ecological influence of bioengineered forests over time. Address potential risks and ethical considerations associated with bioengineering, establishing protocols for containment and adaptive management to respond to unforeseen consequences. Number 22, artificial ozone layer. Conduct a detailed analysis of the target planet's atmospheric composition, focusing on ozone levels, ultraviolet radiation exposure, and potential ozone depleting substances. Develop a comprehensive plan to introduce ozone producing compounds into the atmosphere, aiming to establish an artificial ozone layer that shields the planet from harmful UV radiation. Implement controlled release mechanisms for ozone producing compounds, potentially utilizing specialized satellites or atmospheric probes to disperse the substances evenly across the atmosphere. Model and simulate the interactions between introduced compounds and existing atmospheric components, ensuring that the artificial ozone layer effectively attenuates harmful UV radiation without causing unintended side effects. Establish monitoring systems, including satellite-based instruments and ground-based sensors, to continuously assess the development and stability of the artificial ozone layer, allowing for real-time adjustments as needed. Number 23, cloud seeding. Conduct a thorough analysis of the target planet's atmospheric conditions, humidity levels, and existing cloud formation processes. Develop a cloud seeding strategy involving the introduction of cloud condensation nuclei or other seeding agents to encourage cloud formation and precipitation. Implement advanced seeding technologies, potentially using automated drones or atmospheric probes, to disperse seeding agents at targeted altitudes and locations within the atmosphere. Model the impact of cloud seeding on precipitation patterns, ensuring a balanced distribution of water resources and considering potential downstream effects on planetary ecosystems. Establish a monitoring network, including satellite-based observations and ground-based weather stations, to track changes in cloud cover, precipitation, and overall weather patterns resulting from cloud seeding efforts. Number 24, seeding with extremophiles. Conduct a comprehensive analysis of the target planet's surface conditions, including temperature extremes, radiation levels, and soil composition. Identify extremophilic microorganisms on Earth that exhibit resilience to environmental conditions similar to those on the target planet. Develop a strategy to introduce and cultivate extremophiles on the planet, potentially using bioengineered methods to enhance their adaptability and functionality. Implement controlled release mechanisms, potentially through robotic missions or biopods, to disperse extremophiles across various regions of the planet's surface. Establish monitoring systems, including genetic tracking and ecological surveys, to assess the impact of extremophile seeding on soil quality, nutrient cycling, and overall ecological balance, adapting the strategy based on observed outcomes. Number 25, orbital habitats. Conduct an extensive assessment of the target planet's orbital environment, considering factors such as gravitational forces, radiation levels, and stability of orbital trajectories. Design orbital habitats capable of sustaining human life, integrating life support systems, radiation shielding, and efficient resource utilization within the confined space. Develop advanced construction methods for assembling orbital habitats, potentially involving modular components or 3D printing technologies, and ensure their resilience to space debris and other hazards. Implement a propulsion system for orbital adjustment, allowing habitats to maintain stable orbits and adapt to changes in the planet's gravitational field or other orbital perturbations. Establish protocols for waste management, recycling, and resource replenishment within the orbital habitats to create a self-sustaining environment for long-term human habitation. Number 26. Hydrogen bomb propulsion. Conduct a thorough analysis of the target planet's mass, gravitational field, and orbital parameters to determine the feasibility of using hydrogen bombs for propulsion. Develop a propulsion system that utilizes controlled nuclear explosions for thrust, potentially deploying hydrogen bombs in a directed manner to achieve the desired changes in the planet's orbit or velocity. Implement precision targeting and timing mechanisms to ensure accurate placement and detonation of hydrogen bombs, minimizing unintended consequences and collateral damage. Model and simulate the orbital dynamics and consequences of propulsion events, considering potential impacts on the planet's rotation, axial tilt, and overall orbital characteristics. Establish a comprehensive monitoring and control system to assess the effects of hydrogen bomb propulsion in real time and make necessary adjustments to achieve the desired planetary changes while minimizing risks. Number 27. Mega structures. Conduct a detailed analysis of the target planet's geophysical characteristics, gravitational forces, and atmospheric conditions to inform the design of mega structures. Develop plans for constructing colossal structures such as space-based shields, solar reflectors, or artificial ring systems to influence planetary climate, radiation exposure, or other environmental factors. Implement advanced construction technologies, potentially involving autonomous robotic systems, 3D printing, or assembly in space to build megastructures with precision and efficiency. Consider the long-term stability and environmental impact of megastructures, incorporating materials with high durability and resistance to space conditions. Establish a continuous monitoring system to track the effects of megastructures on the planet's environment, making real-time adjustments to their configuration or operation based on observed outcomes. Number 28. Geodesic domes. Begin by thoroughly analyzing the target planet's atmospheric conditions, temperature fluctuations, and radiation levels to design geodesic domes tailored to the specific environment. Develop advanced materials for dome construction, taking into account factors such as strength, insulation, and resistance to external environmental conditions. Employ innovative architectural designs that maximize internal space while ensuring structural integrity, potentially incorporating reinforced frameworks or flexible materials. Integrate life support systems within the geodesic domes, including air circulation, waste management, and water recycling to create a self-sustaining environment for inhabitants. Implement a modular design approach, allowing for scalability and adaptability to different functions within the domes, such as residential areas, agricultural zones, and recreational spaces. Consider energy sources such as solar panels, advanced power systems, or geothermal energy to meet the needs of the geodesic domes, ensuring long-term viability and independence from external resources. Number 29. Geothermal energy harvesting. Conduct a comprehensive analysis of the target planet's geothermal activity, identifying regions with high thermal gradients, heat reservoirs, and potential for sustainable energy extraction. Design geothermal energy harvesting systems, potentially involving drilling technologies, to access subsurface heat and convert it into usable energy. Implement heat exchange mechanisms एंड पावर जनरेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज केपेबल ऑफ एफिशिएंटली कन्वर्टिंग जियो थर्मल एनर्जी इंटू इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और अदर यूजेबल फॉर्म्स. कंसिडर एनवायरमेंटल इम्पैक्ट असेसमेंट्स टू मिनिमाइज डिस्टर्बेंसेस टू द प्लैनेटरी सब सरफेस एंड प्रिवेंट अनइंटेंडेड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस सच एज साइस्मिक एक्टिविटी और चेंजेस इन थर्मल ग्रेडियंट्स. इस्टेब्लिश कंटिन्यूस मॉनिटरिंग सिस्टम्स इंक्लूडिंग सब सरफेस सेंसर्स एंड सरफेस ऑब्जर्वेशंस टू असेस द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ जियो थर्मल एनर्जी हार्वेस्टिंग एंड इंश्योर इट्स सस्टेनेबल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ओवर टाइम. नंबर 30, क्लाइमेट कंट्रोल सैटेलाइट्स. कंडक्ट ए थोरो एनालिसिस ऑफ द टारगेट प्लैनेट्स क्लाइमेट पैटर्न्स एटमोस्फेरिक कंपोजिशन एंड टेम्परेचर वेरिएशंस टू इन्फॉर्म द डिज़ाइन ऑफ क्लाइमेट कंट्रोल सैटेलाइट्स. डेवलप सैटेलाइट बेस्ड टेक्नोलॉजीज केपेबल ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंसिंग वेदर पैटर्न्स रेगुलेटिंग टेम्परेचर्स और मिटिगेटिंग एक्सट्रीम कंडीशंस थ्रू कंट्रोल्ड इंटरवेंशंस. इम्प्लीमेंट एडवांस्ड ऑर्बिटल डायनामिक्स कैलकुलेशंस टू ऑप्टिमाइज द प्लेसमेंट एंड ट्रैजेक्टरीज ऑफ क्लाइमेट कंट्रोल सैटेलाइट्स इंश्योरिंग प्रेसाइज टारगेटिंग एंड अडेप्टेबिलिटी टू चेंजिंग प्लैनेटरी कंडीशंस. इनकॉर्पोरेट रियल टाइम मॉनिटरिंग एंड फीडबैक सिस्टम्स पोटेंशियली यूटिलाइजिंग सैटेलाइट सेंसर्स एंड ग्राउंड बेस्ड वेदर स्टेशंस टू असेस द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ क्लाइमेट कंट्रोल इंटरवेंशंस एंड मेक डायनामिक एडजस्टमेंट्स. एड्रेस पोटेंशियल एथिकल कंसिडरेशंस एंड अनइंटेंडेड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस associated with large scale climate control incorporating adaptive management strategies to respond to unforeseen developments and prioritize environmental sustainability. So these were the 30 terraforming methods that encompass a wide array of approaches ranging from atmospheric manipulation and solar shading to genetic engineering and megastructure construction. These strategies aim to transform inhospitable planets into habitable environments suitable for life. Atmospheric manipulation involves carefully introducing gases to create a life-supporting atmosphere, while solar shading and mirrors control the planet's exposure to sunlight. Genetic engineering and bioengineering introduce modified organisms to enhance adaptability, and nanotechnology enables precise manipulation at a microscopic scale. Other methods involve large-scale interventions such as fusion bombs or mass drivers for planetary engineering. Whether through altering the geology, redistributing water resources, or harnessing geothermal energy, each method requires meticulous planning, monitoring, and adaptation to achieve successful terraforming. I personally believe that rather than terraforming other planets, more focus should be done on making the Earth a utopia first. Focusing on making Earth a utopia should be prioritized over extensive efforts in terraforming other planets due to the urgency and interconnected nature of global challenges on our home planet. Earth, with its intricate ecosystems and diverse life forms, is uniquely suited to sustain human life. The preservation of Earth's biodiversity, responsible resource management, and addressing pressing issues such as climate change, pollution, and social inequality are paramount. Allocating resources to create a utopian society on Earth involves sustainable practices, renewable energy development, and equitable social structures. Additionally, advancements made in improving life on Earth both environmentally and socially can serve as valuable models for potential space exploration and colonization endeavors in the future. By prioritizing Earth, humanity can lay the groundwork for responsible space exploration while ensuring the well-being of current and future generations on our home planet. I am well aware of the importance of expanding into outer space, but I strongly believe more focus should be done to make Earth a utopia. A symbiotic relationship should be established between these two endeavors. We will be able to harness the knowledge and technological advancements required for responsible space exploration. It could provide a foundation for responsible extraterrestrial endeavors, while simultaneously, space exploration and colonization offer a unique avenue for resource diversification, technological innovation, and the potential for human expansion beyond the confines of our home planet. The challenges of space exploration, such as life support systems, closed-loop ecosystems, and resource utilization, necessitate solutions that can have transformative applications on Earth. By first establishing Earth as a utopia, we not only ensure the well-being of our planet and its inhabitants, but also lay the ethical and sustainable groundwork for venturing into outer space, extending the possibilities of human civilization while preserving the interconnected balance of life on Earth. We can also make millions of VR worlds indistinguishable from reality and experience all the different planet conditions there and have a paradise on Earth. Thank you very much for watching, and may we make the planet Earth a utopia first before heavily allocating large amount of resources in expanding out into outer space.